In general, those who are not practicing devotees, especially those who come from, you could say, Vedic culture, but are not practicing devotees, they only approach Krishna. Many people, like we have Janmashtami festival here, and how many lakhs of people come? How many people come for Jan? More than 10 lakhs of people come through the gates for darshan of Krishna. So many people, they approach Krishna, but they do not know that that is Mayavada. That is Mayavada. Srila Prabhupada said in one place that it is very difficult to approach Krishna. Very, very, very difficult. And then Srila Prabhupada gave the example which I gave 2 days ago on Radhashtami morning, that you cannot associate with fire. From the vantage point of this body and this earthly planet, you can only associate with fire through the emanation of the heat and light. And the heat must be temperamental, conducive also. So in that sense, most people are running after Krishna. But for what? To fulfill their material desires. Even sometimes practicing devotees do that. Akama sarvakamava mokshakama udarani tivrena bhakti yogena yajeta purushampara. But when we closely look at Srila Prabhupada's mood in relation of chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, he reveals something to us that we should be conscious of as a practicing devotees. We have read the glories of chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, and this is one of the most beautiful purports. Srila Prabhupada quotes various acharyas and so forth. Yeah. So Srila Prabhupada says in one place that the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. That one who is constantly engaged, Srila Prabhupada says, in addressing the Lord and His energy, not directly Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama. Cannot directly. Yeah. Srila Prabhupada says that we can just imagine, we cannot actually know. We can just imagine how much the Supreme Lord is obliged to the person who is chanting the holy name. And Srila Prabhupada further says that it is impossible for Krishna to ever forget such a devotee. Impossible for Krishna to ever forget such a devotee. Now everyone in the material world are materially running after Krishna. But Krishna is transcendentally running after Srimati Radharani. But he cannot catch up with Srimati Radharani, because she is transcendentally engaged in running after all the devotees to collect their devotion to offer to Krishna. So when Krishna, in a way, tells Radharani, please stop, you know, I need your association. So she says, I'm too busy. Too busy. Busy doing what? Collecting the devotion of the devotees to offer to Krishna. A wonderful, transparent via medium. So therefore, Hare Krishna, not just Krishna. So at the same time, Krishna becomes bewildered, completely bewildered and confused. How is it as I am hankering for Radharani's association, but she is busy? She is busy. So at the same time, he has a hankering to experience of what she is busy doing. You know? So everyone is running after Krishna, Krishna is running after Radharani, and Radharani is running after the devotees. She's busy doing that. So then Krishna takes the consciousness of Srimati Radharani and becomes, transforms into Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Srila Prabhupada says that the intimate, you get general behavior and you get personal behavior. So Srila Prabhupada said that the personal behavior of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is that he was never distressed but always happy in chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare. So Srila Prabhupada says that when we chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we are following in the footsteps of Lord Chaitanya. And when we chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, Lord Chaitanya follows in the footsteps of the devotee who is chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So it is reciprocal. It is reciprocal. And Srila Prabhupada says very carefully that when one chants the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, Krishna becomes obligated, like I said earlier, to the devotee. But Srila Prabhupada's words are deceptively simple, but very deep, very deep. Like that. So if Krishna becomes obligated to the devotee who is chanting the holy name, so that means there is a difference between the holy name and Krishna himself. In the sense, from Krishna's perspective of feeling obligated. Normally we know Nama Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha, that the holy name of the Lord and the Lord themselves are non-different. Normally we hear like that. See? But that's for the chanter of the holy name. That's the perspective of the chanter. But Krishna's perspective is quite different. Krishna's perspective is that when somebody chants the holy name, he is indebted, he is obliged to that person. It is not the holy name, it is Krishna himself. So that's the difference. Like that. So therefore it can be safely concluded that the holy name is more powerful than Krishna, because it brings Krishna to be obligated to the devotee. Now, Srila Prabhupada mentions here about the offenses to the holy name. And the offenses are quite negative. Don't do this, don't do that. You know, avoiding the 10 offenses. One should not blaspheme the devotees of the Lord, sadhu ninda. You know? Like that. Don't do. One should not. One should not. One should not. Like that, yeah. So that's the negative. Then one disciple asked Srila Prabhupada, you know, this is like avoiding, 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 not, 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 not. What's the positive side? What's the other side so that we can chant the holy name purely? Then Srila Prabhupada replied to the disciple that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave us three principles, and from those principles I have given the details in my books. And those three principles are nama, gana, asada, ruchi. Is that one should increase one's attachment and taste for the holy name. And then Srila Prabhupada said, not externally, but internally. Yes. And when one develops attachment and taste for chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, then one's heart becomes soft. Like that. One does not become proud that I am a great chanter of the holy name. One's heart becomes soft. So when the heart becomes soft, then the person develops compassion for those who are not chanting the holy name. And then the person transforms that compassion of the soft heart into becoming a preacher. Is to bring others to chant the holy name of the Lord. And that Prabhupada says, Mahaprabhu's principle of jivadoya. Yeah. So when you preach to people who are not chanting the holy name to come to chant the holy name, new people, then one feels the, you could say, misery of how the people are suffering. See? How the people are suffering. Paradukaduki, how the people are suffering. Like that. But in that internal state of suffering, one also needs shelter. One also needs shelter. Like that. So by giving Krishna consciousness, especially the holy name, to others who are not in Krishna consciousness, one also needs to be sandwiched. You cannot just give shelter. You have to also feel sheltered. If it's one way, you become Krishna. You take the place of Krishna. Become Ishvara Bhav. So therefore, one must feel sheltered. And Srila Prabhupada said that to feel sheltered means Vaishnav Seva. That to surrender to Krishna means to surrender to the devotees of Krishna. Not a devotees, but plural devotees of Krishna. Therefore we say Anant Koti Vaishnav Vrindakija, devotees of Krishna. So when we surrender to the devotees of Krishna through serving them, Vaishnav Seva, then we feel sheltered, and then we offer the shelter to others by giving them the holy name. Jivadoya, Vaishnav Seva, Jivadoya. And these three things, at some point, one may be more prominent than the other. Like in these few days, from Radhastami afternoon, evening, till now, the most prominent activity is Nama, Gana, Sada, Ruchi. But not at the expense entirely of Jivadoya and Vaishnav Seva. Like that. Like when we do the book distribution marathon, the most prominent activity is Jivadoya. Like that. See? And then when we arranging festivals like the Kirtan Mela, the organizers do a lot of Vaishnav Seva. You know, prasadam, accommodation, you know, things like that. See? Yeah. But one must not be superior to the other. All three are necessary for one to chant the holy name of the Lord in the humble state of consciousness. All three things are necessary. Chanting the holy names, Jiva Doya, as well as Vaishnav Seva. Yeah. If we more prominently just chant the holy name without Vaishnav Seva, then you will just enjoy the holy name. See? If you just more prominently chant the holy name without Jiva Doya, giving the holy name to those who are bereft of such, you know, suffering in the material world, then again you will enjoy the holy name. But if you engage in Jiva Doya, preaching to others, and you engage in Vaishnav Seva, serving the devotees, then the heart will naturally serve the holy name. You'll get out of the Ishvara Bhav. You'll get out of the that situation and you'll come to the actual constitutional position of the living entity, Jivara Swarupai Krishnara Nitya Dasa 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 Anudas. In that way. Now, Srila Prabhupada has repeated so many times that one can go to the supreme planet, Param Vrajat, simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. But our mission in the mood of Srila Prabhupada is not to go back on our own. Everyone individually from a personal level should feel that I should be the last one to go back. Let everyone go back before me. Yeah. So we don't chant the holy name to go back to Godhead. We chant the holy name to bring others to go back home, back to Godhead. And that is the principal consciousness of Srimati Radharani, which is very nicely given to us, you know, in between the lines in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, in the last chapter, Ancha Lila, chapter 20. You can read about Srimati Radharani there. So therefore, chanting the holy name of the Lord is a very important or principal stay, mainstay of the process of devotional service. So it is a process of devotional service means to serve us, to serve the holy name and not to enjoy the holy name. But in the beginning stages, when one chants the holy name of the Lord, especially for new people and beginning devotees, it is good that they come to enjoy the holy name. So that will give them a higher sense of so-called enjoyment in comparison to the material world. So when one is attracted to enjoy the holy name, then one enjoys the holy name through one's senses, material senses, through one's material mind, and through one's philosophical or intellectual appeal. Oh, this sounds nice. It's good, yeah. So most new people and most beginning devotees, it's good enough that they come to enjoy the holy name. But Srila Prabhupada wants us to go further. After being purified by enjoying the holy name, then one comes to the point of simply serving the holy name. And therefore it is the principal item as given in these verses of the nine processes of devotion. It's not service, today's verse. It's the principal item of devotional service, not devotional enjoyment. But initially it will be enjoyment. It will trap you. It is better than enjoying in the material world. Then you will come to the internal state of serving the holy name. So today is a wonderful day that you have been enjoying the holy name, some of us, for the last many hours. So try to get into the mode of I'm doing the principal item of devotional service. I'm here to serve the holy name. And that comes from the heart, not through the mind and the senses and the intelligence. It comes from the heart. So you please join in the kirtan from 9 o'clock, and as much as you can, and hear the holy name, serve the holy name. Do you have any comments or questions? We have our illustrious, wonderful devotee, Mukunda Datta Prabhu. Can you contribute some words of wisdom for us? He has great attachment and taste for the holy name, so he can help us along. At least help me along. Param Vijaya Shri Krishna Sanketan. So he is glorifying the holy name. Thank you. We have any comments, further comments or questions? I'm about to say something, but you got to digest it maybe. Is that okay? Let me take a little while to think. If you chant japa, and if 16 rounds is enough, then you won't be inclined to perform Vaishnav Seva. Because you have other priorities. And after you chant your 16th round of japa, and you tell Krishna, this is enough, I have other things to do. I don't want to be too Krishna conscious to you. But if you have it in you that 16 rounds of japa is not enough, then you will be easily inclined to do Vaishnav Seva. Is it digesting? It is like interdependent. In other words, when you serve Vaishnavas, then you'll be inclined to, in your consciousness, that 16 rounds of japa is not enough. See? But if you don't serve Vaishnavas, 16 rounds is enough. So the more you serve Vaishnavas, the more you'll feel 16 rounds is not enough. And the more 16 rounds is not enough, the more you will serve Vaishnavas. It is interdependent. It is? Yeah. That is shelter. That is shelter. Both the holy name and service to Vaishnavas. That is shelter. It is our only shelter. It is the only wealth of a devotee. There's no other better wealth than this. And no money can buy this. No amount of value, anything materially or spiritually can buy this. Not even a lapis lazuli. You know what's a lapis lazuli? It is a transcendental gemstone that is used as the foundation in Dwarka. Not even on top. Not even a chintamani jewel can match this wealth. Digesting? Oh, you have another question on the answer. Just stick to that. It cannot be philosophized. It cannot be we could say disgust. You just do it. The moment you think 16 rounds is enough of japa, then go and serve the Vaishnava. Then you'll come to the point of 16 rounds is not enough. And when 16 rounds is not enough, then you'll internally go to the point of, you know, looking forward to look for Vaishnavas to serve, even if you cannot find anyone. But we don't have to look. So many are there. So many in the community of devotees. Is that okay? And then there's a challenge comes, a challenge. And the challenge is that, and you know, I face the challenge as a sannyasi. It is easier to serve, but it is more difficult to accept service as a service. Initially, it is even difficult to serve. It is even difficult to serve. But it will become easier to serve, but then it becomes more difficult to accept service as a service. And that's the test from Krishna. Like as a sannyasi, I have to accept so much service from so many devotees. But it is very risky, very risky. So it's more difficult to accept service as a service. So just serve. Just serve. But the beginning devotees, oh, I want to be served. I want to be served. Let everyone serve me. Now. That means completing neophyte and 16 rounds is enough. See? So there's three levels of that internal consciousness. So I'll just give, you have your hand up. Now we'll conclude with this. Because we have to stop at 9 and our chanting of the holy name should continue. I don't want to take time from chanting the holy name. You know, generally, we are like sort of taught, or maybe it's a type of culture that's there, maybe partially the culture. You know, generally we are taught, oh, you have to serve the guru, you have to serve the sannyasis, you have to serve the senior devotees. Generally it's like that, right? Yeah. You know, it's like a senior devotee, you know, he won't take the broom and sweep, you know. Bhakta so-and-so, 2 weeks, he must come and sweep. Understand? And generally. We should be serving the senior devotees. We should be serving Shiksha and Diksha gurus. We should be serving sannyasis. That should be there. That's fine. Yeah. But you know, senior devotees and initiating gurus and instructing gurus and sannyasis are within Daivi Varna Ashram Dharma. This junior and senior is within Daivi Varna Ashram Dharma. You get the four ashrams and you get the four varnas. It's within that. You serve a brahmana. You know, you serve. Yeah. Yeah. But Krishna consciousness is not. Daivi Varna Ashram Dharma is like a stepping stone. But Krishna consciousness is actually the greater family, and we belong to the Achyuta Gotra. The family of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is a little above Daivi Varna Ashram Dharma. Although Daivi Varna Ashram Dharma is important for the mass of people in general. Now, in a cultured family, which member of the family is protected and given the most service? The baby, yes, the child. The baby. Although everyone else is served, the father is served, the mother is served, the child, but the baby. See? So when you get the Mahaprasad plate, don't bring it to the sannyasis. You take it to the devotees who is wearing yellow first and serve them. And serve them. Sit down and we serve you. So when they become sannyasis, or they become, you know, experienced devotees, they'll also do it to the, yeah, they are babies. They are just few months, few weeks, few years. You understand? Yeah. So this is the Krishna conscious culture. It is not the Devi Varna Ashram culture. So they'll learn when they get older, they should also serve the younger ones. Because the younger ones are easily prone to leave again, isn't it? So give them the best. Give them the best Mahagalan. Give them the best sweets. Give them the best accommodation. So they will not go back. And when they get experienced, you know, then they will do it to the new ones also. Oh, these are new devotees. We have to take care of them nicely. They are delicate. They are sensitive. Their faith is soft and pliable. We have to make them firm, strong. They should feel they left that other family. We are the actual family. Like that. We should serve everyone, including those who are crippled, invalid, and sick. That's also there. But the newest ones should be given special attention. Like that. It takes, Prabhupada said, it takes so much, gallons and gallons of blood to make one person a devotee. So let's maintain them and keep them. That's Vaishnava Seva. It is easy to serve seniors, easy to serve the guru and so forth. But to serve somebody who's your junior, so to speak, you know, that takes a lot. And that's Trinadapi Sunechena Tarorapi Sahisnana Amanena Managena Kirtanyasa. That takes a lot. When I was serving as a president in Krishna Balaram Mandir, co-president, yeah, one day I took the broom and began sweeping. Five devotees, Prabhu, you can't do this. I said, that is caste system. I'm not a Brahmana. I'm a Malecha. I'll do it. If it is good enough for Shamananda Pandit, you know Dukhi Krishna Das? Dukhi Krishna Das. If it is good enough for Shamananda Pandit, he was personally initiated by Radharani. You know? If it's good enough for him to sweep, and he was sweeping where the pigs were in the dam. Such a great acharya. Yeah. So therefore, everyone should be served. So it is easy to serve, but it is very difficult to accept service as a service. Remember that. Yeah. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Ananta koti Vaishnava Vrinda ki jai. Kirtan Mela Yajna ki jai.